Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining BGP Communities. Now, before we go into the content of this video, I'd just like to remind you to subscribe to my channel if you like the content that I'm sharing. And if you have any ideas for future topics, please describe those in the comments below, as some of you have already done. And if you do like this video, please make sure to click that thumbs up button. BGP Communities are a feature of BGP that provides a way to group destinations in a network and to apply routing decisions based on those groupings. They're essentially tags or labels that can be attached to routes, enabling more flexible and granular control over routing policies. Now, these communities appear within BGP updates as attributes. Now, why are they called communities? Well, it's because they represent a way to categorize or to group routes into sets that share common properties or behaviors. The term community evokes the idea of a collection or a group, which is precisely what these attributes enable. The grouping of routes based on shared characteristics for the purpose of applying common policies. Now, community is defined by a 32-bit value that is essentially added as an attribute to a particular route. Now, traditionally, BGP communities were represented as a pair of 16-bit values, often written in the format X colon Y, where X and Y are integers. More recently, extended communities, which are 64-bit values, have been introduced, and large communities, which use a different 96-bit format. These have been introduced for more flexibility, which are essentially useful for extensively large networks. Now, other than the types of communities, as far as the format of the community values goes, there are also what are known as well-known communities. Now, these communities have predefined policies that are applied by default by all BGP routers. Whenever these communities are encountered attached to a particular route, those routes are handled in very specific ways. Now, what are these well-known communities and how do routers behave when they see them? Well, first of all, we have the default community. Some people call it the internet community or the network community. This community is essentially applied to all routes by default. When this community is present, we simply advertise the prefix to all BGP neighbors. Then we have the no advertise community. Now, this community tells a BGP router not to advertise the prefix to any BGP neighbors. The no export well-known community tells the BGP router not to advertise the prefix to any eBGP neighbors. And finally, the no export subconfed is a community that tells a BGP router not to advertise the prefix outside of the local sub AS. Now, this particular community is used in the context of BGP confederations. If you're not familiar with confederations, take a look at my related video on confederations that's found in the description below. Now, up to this point, this might sound very theoretical and you may not have fully understood how these communities work. For this reason, let's take a look at a couple of the well-known communities and see how they affect the way BGP routers share routes. Take a look at this topology. Now, this router here is advertising the 20.20.20.0/24 network into AS100 using BGP. Via iBGP, R1 learns of this route. Now, R1 is configured to add the no advertised community to this route before it sends the BGP update to R2. So if we take a look at the BGP update, we will see that for the 20.20.20.0/24 route, we have a BGP attribute that's attached here, which is the well-known community of no advertise. Now, R2 receives this update and processes it. It will place the 20.20.20.0/24 network into its own BGP table, but the community will affect how it advertises it. Will it advertise the route to its BGP neighbors? The no advertise community states that a BGP router must not advertise this route to any other BGP neighbors. So R2 does not advertise the network to either its IBGP neighbor of R3 or its EBGP neighbor of R4. Now, what about the no export community? What if R2 here receives the no export community attached to the root in its BGP update? It will still install the root into its own BGP table, but it won't advertise it to any eBGP neighbors. That means that R3 will receive the update because it's an IBGP neighbor, but not R4, which is the eBGP neighbor. Now, what happens if the BGP community is updated with a value of 0:0? Now, this is the special case, sometimes called the internet community, as we mentioned before. And it simply says, advertise the network to all BGP peers. So here, R2 will advertise the 20.20.20.0/24 network to R3 and to R4. Now, so far, we've seen the well-known communities and how they're applied. What about customized communities? How are those applied and how can they be useful? Well, let's say that we've configured R1 to add the community of 65228:15 to the 20.20.20.0/24 root. And this root is advertised to R2. How can that be useful? Well, there are a multitude of things that we can do with this. I'll give you just some examples of what you can do, and hopefully that'll give you an idea of the great variety of ways you can manipulate BGP routing in this fashion. As R2 receives this route, we can perform traffic engineering. For example, R2 may use this community to perform AS path prepending before being advertised to other eBGP peers, thus making the path via R2 less preferable. This can be done by applying a route map on R2 that prepends ASPath 160 several times for all routes tagged with the 65228:15 community when advertising to certain peers. Now, you can also use this community for route prioritization. You can have R2 apply a route map that sets a higher local preference for routes tagged with this community. You can also perform route filtering. Apply a route map that denies routes with this community from being advertised to specific neighbors. This is similar to the well-known communities of no export and no advertise, but it can be made much more specific to particular neighbors. Another use of this community could be geographic control. You can apply a route map that advertises routes with this community only within Europe, for example, and prevents their advertisement to non-European peers. So you see that since communities are simply tags or labels that are set on particular routes that create communities or groupings of routes, you can then apply anything you like to each community using route maps. So you have a great level of flexibility and granularity to what you can actually achieve using communities. So that's a general overview of communities, how they work, and what they're used for. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.